Changing Lanes, the official podcast of BMW.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this episode of Changing Lanes, the official podcast of BMW. My name is Sarah.
And I'm Jonathan.
And today in the podcast, we are ready to start the new year off right. 2020 was not at all what we expected. It was not an easy year for many of us, but we somehow managed to persevere. We made it through. And now in 2021, you may have some New Year's resolutions, for example, on how to stay fit.
I know I do. That's one of mine, most definitely.
And we've got something that is a little out of the box, but tons of fun. So something that is out of the ordinary, but we really do think you will get a kick out of it.
Most definitely. Okay. Our New Year's resolution sport of choice is, wait for it, urban kayaking.
Yes, I'm not so sure that this was what our podcast listeners were expecting, Jonathan.
Yeah, I know. But just give me a minute. Give us a minute to explain this, okay?
So yes, if you've never heard of this, urban kayaking, which is also known as city kayaking, it combines the agility and comfort of regular recreational kayaking with life in the city. So just imagine this scenario, okay? Paddling along the canals of your favorite metropolis, soaking in the sun, fresh air, skyline views, all from a kayak.
Sounds pretty cool, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, although urban kayaking is best done not during the winter season, still, we have a lot of podcast listeners in the Southern Hemisphere where it is summertime right now.
True.
Right? So there's something to be said about taking to the cities to explore canals and inner city waterways, giving a whole new meaning to kayaking. Now, this is a whole new twist on kayaking, and it's trending like crazy. So if you have a kayak car rack and installed.
Or maybe you got a car rack as a Christmas present.
Exactly. And your kayak is loaded and you're ready to take off, but you don't know where to go from here. Where do you find kayaking experiences that are truly out of the ordinary? Somewhere that allows you to escape the usual overrun tourist spots?
Well, look no further. We have got you covered.
Yes.
So everyone, here are our top five travel destinations to experience the phenomenon known as urban kayaking.
Yes. All right, here we go. With number one on our list, we have Tokyo, Japan. Urban kayaking in the mega metropolis with bright neon lights and skyscrapers galore? Really? Yes. Tokyo is where it's at for urban kayaking. Why? Well, thanks to its many canals, visitors can tour the financial districts or residential areas all via kayak.
Yeah, and a highlight for anyone looking to experience Tokyo with a paddle in their hands is Sakura, or cherry blossom season, which takes place in a very limited time window each year, usually around March or April. Paddling through the romantic canals covered with pink petals and soaking in the seasonal highlight is definitely on my bucket list.
Oh man, sounds amazing. You know, just make sure to book in advance, especially during cherry blossom season. I mean, we would not want you to miss out on this beautiful experience and it being all booked out.
No, exactly. Well, let's move on to number two on our list, and that is Copenhagen, Denmark.
Yes.
You know, Jonathan, few cities on the European map offer better opportunities for urban kayaking than Copenhagen.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, the city is actually built around an elaborate system of canals and small harbor inlets. And what's more, navigating the city by car isn't difficult. And parking spots right next to the canals are easy to find.
That's important.
For sure. And from here, you just simply jump into your kayak and you'll be met by fellow kayakers and locals who rent paddle boats and small dinghies to navigate the waters.
Sounds great. And, you know, there's no need to worry about it being overcrowded with tourists. Copenhagen has tons of routes, and you can paddle your way around the city with ease. You know, even as a total beginner like me, you know, you can start on the piers next to the National Parliament, close to the famed Christianshavn Canal front, and make your way around the city. There'll be highlights that include the Copenhagen Opera House, the tiny romantic canals dotted with houseboats and waterfront cafes, and even brand new residential areas that have been built with the water as an integral element of daily life.
Yeah, gosh, it sounds so beautiful. This is for sure another trip I'd definitely love to take.
So, next on our list, coming in at number 3, is Chicago, USA.
Ooh, I wasn't expecting that.
Exactly. Now, most people will not think of Chicago as a prime destination for urban kayaking, but hear me out. So this is a huge hotspot for kayaking, which is in the canals that run next to the famous Chicago Riverwalk. And they offer stunning views of the cityscape and ideal conditions for beginners and even advanced kayakers alike. And another great alternative is to enjoy the tour down the equally famous Chicago Lakefront, which will take you into Lake Michigan, no less. So this is going to give you the opportunity to see the city's trademark skyline from the open waters. An Instagrammable moment if ever there was one.
Yeah. And even the drive from downtown Chicago is just less than 10 minutes to the waterfront. So that means you can easily visit the hot spots like the Millennium Park and Navy Pier and go kayaking all in one day.
Perfect. Win-win situation.
Yes. Okay, moving on to number 4 in our list is Cork, Ireland. Jonathan, this urban kayaking experience is truly out of the ordinary.
Yeah, it sounds it.
The drive alone up to Cork on the southern Irish coast is a scenic route with breathtaking views.
Wow.
Now, the thing is, historically, Cork has a reputation for its industry. It's been a key harbor hub. But in recent years, Cork has become a tourist destination for people who want to enjoy its wealth of art galleries and ancient castles and breweries and markets and museums. And because it's a harbor city, there are tons of opportunities to unpack your kayak, drop it right into the city's canals, and take off on a tour that'll give you a new perspective on the city.
Wow.
Cork is a must-see city, and urban kayaking is a must-do activity when you're there, Jonathan.
Wow, sounds like a dream. You know, I never would have expected to have a reason to go to Cork, but this urban kayaking in Cork sounds really cool.
I love the combination of castles and kayaking,
yeah.
And Cork offers both. So yeah, definitely a must-visit place.
Beautiful. All right, last but not least, number 5 on our list could possibly sound like one of your dreams come true, Sarah, living La Dolce Vita.
Oh, yes, definitely. I love that.
Number 5 on our list is none other than Venice, Italy.
Yes, where else could you possibly find better urban kayaking options than in a city that is literally built on water? Yeah, I mean, this is the intricate system of canals that's made up the city's pulse for centuries. Oh my gosh, it's amazing.
You know, Venice offers so much for the urban kayaker, exploring the most famous canals in the world. The unique perspective on a city that's rich in detail and architecture, it just invites explorers to take to the waters with their kayak and discover all these hidden gems from the water.
Venice truly has it all. Well, except for parking.
It's very
true. Not a
true.
Lot of parking in Venice. I mean, I love this city. It's gorgeous, but forget about trying to drive there. So if you do arrive by car, parking definitely going to be a problem. So I would recommend that plan ahead, and you can either take a plane to a neighboring city or you can take the train to Venice, rent a kayak, and that way you're going to avoid a lot of headaches and you'll be able to focus on experiencing the city on foot or, as we keep saying, via kayak.
Great tip, Sarah. Awesome.
Yes, anything for the Dolce Vita.
You know, I definitely want to get out onto the canals and start exploring and seeing cities that I know from a totally different angle. I mean, that sounds like a fun idea, and it's going to keep you fit as well.
Yeah, and you know, sometimes getting a new perspective on things can make all the difference. Mm. And with urban kayaking, it's definitely a new perspective to try out. I bet not a lot of people have even heard about this kind of activity, and maybe it'll mean that more people try it out.
Exactly. Can't wait.
So everyone, thank you so much for listening to this week's episode of Changing Lanes.
If you enjoyed this episode, make sure you subscribe to our podcast for future episodes.
And to dive deeper into all things BMW, head on over to bmw.com to learn more.
I'm Jonathan.
And my name is Sarah.
And this has been Changing Lanes.
Hope you join us next time.